And then I was very, very influenced by Wynton Marsalis, particularly during the Black Codes period. It's the way that he would double up the bass lines with a left-handed piano, and his use of hemiola patterns, and how he would break those up between different instruments, and how he'd have melody lines that would move in contrary shapes that move contrary to each other, or change them up to move by certain intervals. And there's so much wit in the way that he would write. It's like so logical, yet it's so it can be so out of the box at the same time. He's more known for I don't know. I shouldn't say that. I'll just say that I recently did a tour with Wynton, with the jazz at Lincoln Center Orchestra, and his writing is so brilliant even today. There's so much there, and yes, he pulls a lot from the tradition, but he's also got that this genius that can really take all these different influences and textures and influence from classical music and from the whole history of jazz, and makes it into something that's truly unique. So Wynton's had a colossal influence on me. Steve Coleman, I'd say more rhythmic, thinking about having like multiple time signatures stacked on top of each other and all these different ways of approaching rhythm, I'd say that's influenced me a lot. Mulgrew Miller, your dad, Donald Brown, I'd say that they've influenced me harmonically and conceptually. Donald Brown has influenced me a lot as far as different ways to think about harmony and to get past it, like head in solos, head out type of mentality, things a little bit more through composed. I'm trying to think of who else. I've been influenced by classical music. I've definitely been influenced by classical music, my classical background, my classical clarinet background. My parents having playing Torando in the house all the time, and Madame Butterfly and things like that. That has influenced me compositionally. And also, I listen to a lot of gospel hip hop. To this day, I love gospel hip hop. You know, groups like Trip Lee and the Cross Movement and those kind of bands. I'd say that when I'm chilling, when I'm not studying, if I'm not listening to jazz, I'm listening to gospel hip hop. That's I spend a lot of time with that. And don't be surprised if a gospel hip hopper turns up on one of my projects one day.